Ladies and gentlemen, Bertha Warrior here. We go higher mindset marketing. I'm here on a road trip. If you look at those beautiful homes, isn't that beautiful? Over here on Wilshire Boulevard in Los Angeles. Beautiful, beautiful home. Well, let me get to the topic. If you look at my topic today, ladies and gentlemen, is become a money magnet. You might say, well, what do you mean by that, Bertha? What do you mean by becoming a money magnet? If you think about it, ladies and gentlemen, in life in general, right, it's all about solving problems, right? If you look around, there's problems all over the place. Look on the news, look in the newspaper, there's problems, problems, problems. So the person that solves the most problem wins. So if you think about it, if you sell weight loss product, right? At this time of the year, most people want to lose a few pounds, right? So this is an ideal time to, you know, put your ads out there to, you know, to lose weight, whether it's 10, 15 pounds, right? Whatever it is. But here's the thing. A lot of us have a lot of different products that we offer to people, right? But here it is. Everybody needs it, right? But not everybody wants it. So, well, you know, so don't feel bad when somebody say no. That means to say, hey, Felicia, hope you're doing fine, my friend. Happy New Year to you. And so if you think about it, okay, so for some people might do travel, right? Everybody would like to take a vacation, you know, but then they might not have the funds or whatever. So then that might not be the person. But listen to this. That person might have a friend that they know that they can refer to you, right? Or I know I have a friend that's in, you know, sells makeup. And then so I refer people to her, right? So you find the people, if you're not the one that offering that particular product, find the people that you have in your circle that you can refer people to, right? So if you think about it, ladies and gentlemen, the person that solves the most problem wins. Okay, so if you want to, as an entrepreneur, if you want to solve, want to make more money, or you need to find bigger problems to solve, right? Everywhere you go, there's a problem. Now, I don't care what area or what business you're in, there is a problem to solve, right? And so instead of having your business maybe in a large, in a general topic, you might just want to scale it down to maybe one. Maybe you could just focus on one product that you have in your store. For me, I have clean products, right? Healthful product, organic products for the home, cleaning products for the home. So then some time I focus on one product, right? Highlight one product, you know, find the individual that one product could sell, right? For instance, if you want a mom, you know, and you're looking for maybe, you know, having a relaxing day, right? I might offer maybe some bat oil or maybe some oils that I would have in my storehouse. So whatever that is, just scale it down. Don't make it so broad that you miss people. You know, you need to find your target market. I think that's what I'm saying. You need to find your target market. Who is your target market? Yes, a lot of people might need to lose the weight, but not everybody wants to lose weight, right? If you think about it, not everybody wants to lose weight. So find out maybe one area, one age group, you know, one location, you know, so you got to kind of scale it down to a specific group, okay? So then some people might want to just generate more leads for their business. My daughter back there, since I said we on this road trip over, I think, 3.5 hours this morning, so she's back there sleeping. And so if you think about it, right, if you want to generate more leads or have more exposure to your website, what do you need to do? You need to either buy traffic or figure out a way to go on Facebook. I know Facebook doing a lot of changes. Go on Facebook and find of ways that you can promote your business, right? And have it set up in such a way that you'll be able to generate leads, right? Whether or not you're putting your links there, I mean, I suggest not to put your link all over the place, but maybe you can just tell them to call you or tell them, you know, or send them to a capture page, whatever that is for you, right? You need to figure out a way. You need to have a system in place in order to get more people to your offer, right? You need to have a system in place. I mean, We all busy mom, busy dad. We need to have a system in place that we be able to generate and market our businesses. Think about that for a minute there. Also, if you think about it, if you are need to build a website, there's the different areas you can go to build a website. And here is the thing, ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to do all the things by yourself. There's places that you can go that people can do it for you for a little of nothing. You got Fiverr out there that can do it for $5, right? So there's different places you can go that can help you. I mean, for myself, I mean, some graphic stuff I don't like to do, so I would send that out to somebody else to do. So there's different ways that we can be work smarter, right? But not hard. I don't know. I don't like to work hard. I mean, sometimes I find myself going to that way, but then it's like, okay, you catch yourself and said, hey, that's a better way to market, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to become a money, a magnet, or become better at your craft, just figure a way to solve more problems, okay? Sometime we might have to solve a lot of small problems to get to the big problems, right? But then remember, in life, there's problems all over the place. So just figure what it is that you're passionate about, right? And then go ahead and market that. I mean, for me, I think in this is 2018, people need more than just a job. But one job is fine, but it's not enough. Okay, it's not enough. And then why would you want to do things the hard way, working for 20, 30 years? And then what you, I mean, these days you don't even get a watch, right? If you think about it, you don't even get that. So why not go ahead and work hard for yourself? Work hard for yourself. I mean, when you get off work, maybe you need to go ahead and make those phone calls, right? If you think about it, if working hard for yourself, it might be a limited time, maybe 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, based on how much time you have to put in there. But if you focus, like focus, FOCUS, right? And I have it on here. It says focus on one course until success. So focus on one area. Don't be like me. Sometimes I'm multitasking. That's not very good. You want to focus on one specific thing, get that project done, and then move on to something else. And if you want to say, be make it simple, do the biggest task first, get that done first, and then you can focus on the smaller tasks later on. I hope that makes sense. So, if you want to, 2018 is here, and most of us, we want to grow in all areas of our life. We want to do bigger things, more things. And if you think about doing bigger things, why not do big things and reap a reward, getting paid for it? Yeah, I mean, we're not everything we do is not going to be a monetary rewards, right? But there's a reward anyway, right? So, ladies and gentlemen, just go out there and figure out how you can be a better a marketer. How can you be a better problem solver, right? Because that's what we're here to do, solve problems. Hey, Lori, hope you're having a fantastic day, my friend. Happy New Year to you and your family. So think about it. Go out there and solve problems. That's what we're here for. Whether we are a Christian, we're here to draw people to show them Jesus Christ, right? Entrepreneur is no difference. Okay, we have a product, right? We're here to share. Give value, give more value, and add more value. And by us doing that, not only are we helping others, but by helping them, we increasing our pocketbook, right? Because if you think about, if we're doing something, shouldn't we get paid for it? The Bible talks about that. We should get paid for what we do. So just think about that for a minute there. I know some people say, well, money is not everything. Yes, money is almost everything. Where can you go without money? Hello, where can you go without money? So money is next up there with oxygen. Okay, if I want to go from here to New York, I got to get the plane tickets. Like right now, I'm here in Los Angeles. I had to put gas in the car, right? It costs money. So money is not air, it's up there with oxygen. It's an exchange. Money is an exchange. And if we continue to say money is an exchange and continue to love money for what it can do for us, why not? If we have more money, we can help more people as believers, right? We can help more people. We can help more people all around the world. We can help more family members, right? So there's nothing wrong with money. It's like it's not the love of money. Is that the love of money is the root of evil, right? But there's the love of money. But what are you going to do with the money? Money is not evil in itself, but it's what you do with it, right? If you think about that. So just want to leave you with that, ladies and gentlemen. And then remember too, Jeremiah 29:11 tells us, for the plans I have for you, the Lord said, he has plans for us. He wants to prosper us. And if he wants to do that, why don't we just go ahead and let him prosper us? And then after we get the funds, then we figure out who are we going to help once you get the funds. You know, I would like to have more funds. I mean, there's so many things that needs attention. You got, you know, people. I remember we got off the freeway and there was somebody there that needed help. And my husband gave him, I think he had like a candy bar or something in the car. And then by us doing that, people was honking, you know, he's like, move on. And there was no place for us to go. I mean, hello, it's just one car up front. So, you know, as we going on, ladies and gentlemen, and reaching other people, okay, whether it's in our business or our relationship with Christ, you know, just be more mindful of the reason behind what we're doing, okay? Just be more mindful. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bird the Warrior with Go Higher Mindset Marketing. And I hope you guys have a super awesome Wednesday. Until tomorrow, talk to you guys soon.